What it is, what it ain't, y'all know it's Top Cat 100 going hard in the Paint the Real Fit TV, which you know you tuned in to. Let's go ahead on and get that out the way. Salute to the whole 100 mob. I'm back up in the gate, doing what I want to do and saying what I want to say. To all my haters, your room often smells like Subway, anchovies, and red onions. Your non-original K-Solo red man face-ass nigga. Now go in the corner and listen to Le Duval. Straight up and down. Now, I mean, I'm rocking right now, bro. I'm coming out saying anything to you. Now, I'm trying to enjoy my birthday. Say happy birthday to a real nigga. Yeah, it's me. You know what I'm talking about? That's why I ain't put out the video. Don't be trying to tell me if I don't put out this. Here come y'all come with the threats again. You know what I'm saying? Those type of subs I got. Nigga told me if I ain't put out the BBGD video that he was going to come see about me. Straight up. That nigga put Lake Charles, Louisiana on it. I said, damn, that nigga dropped it. You know what I'm saying? The Addy and all. So let me get to the video, man. Now, basically, we've been hearing what been going on with BBGD. And we've been seeing all of these locations in the past week that he been dropping. You understand what I'm saying? Now, when we talk about locations, we got to talk about who is up on who. You get what I'm saying? Because we know with him being Fat Thang's son, he's one of the main people that's being targeted by the opposing side, allegedly. Now, here's what I think it is. Now, when you had Baby Joe up on one of these, you know what I'm saying, vlogs, and he was walking on West Buchanan and going through the cut, he went to the Blue Store. People who are familiar with Highland Road and the AM Mock and all of that, people is familiar with the Blue Store across the street. You understand what I'm saying? So now, when you walk in that busy highway, you're a prune to anybody seeing you. You get what I'm saying? And basically, the way he was out there shouldn't have happened in the first place. But BBGD is not one that you about to tell how to live and what to do. You understand what I'm saying? Now, it's only a few people that can do that. Now, here's what I want to say about the whole situation. Y'all was on live with this guy, hyping it up. You see what I'm saying? And now when stuff like this happen, y'all want a video like this, and y'all want me to try to make it as if that y'all don't have nothing to do with it. And I'm not talking about the 100 mob and the people who just watch these videos that just want to know what's going on with NBA and TBG and all of that. I'm talking about the ones that know completely what's going on, that go up on TBG comments. And yeah, I see you niggas. And then you go up on NBA Youngboy comments and the rest of the BBG's comments. And y'all niggas act like that y'all saying that, yeah, man, it's forget this group and forget that group. And then you go over there and say the same thing, bro. You niggas is lame, bro. And at the end of the day, I felt like if people didn't eat this on when he was on live and stuff like that, and you know what I'm saying, that, hey, it probably could have went different. And I'm not saying that it really could have, seeing that he's out here in the middle of the road, in the middle of the street, and dropping locations. I mean, what was meant to happen was meant to happen. But what I'm saying is, basically, he wouldn't have felt the need to do that if people weren't up there egging it on. You see what I'm saying? Hey, at the end of the day, we seen what happened to BBG Iraq, and we seen how serious this could get, and we seen how serious people are with it. So, with all this being said, you gotta move different, and you gotta move accordingly. Now, with that being said, he was strapped. You see what I'm saying? So, it ain't like, allegedly. Now, it ain't like that if you got the thing on you that you can't be got at the same time. You got to keep that in mind, and you got to always remember that. I don't want people to not remember that, because it seems like a lot of people is forgetting that. Now, everybody keep on seeing what's happening with rappers and seeing what's happening in these situations. Now, it's all up to us to keep on paying attention to it, bro. At this point in time, with us losing all the people we lost in the last past 2 weeks, you see what I'm saying? It's time to reevaluate how we move out here, bro. And I've been said that as far as moving around with Kevlar. You see what I'm saying? You know, at the end of the day, man, that $500 could probably save your life at the end of the day. I mean, now, allegedly, you know what I mean, BBGD got hit in the mouth and stuff like that. You get what I'm saying? So, obviously, he was in critical condition. I don't know why people is writing him off and stuff like that. And all of this is alleged. But what I want people to understand is that this could happen to anybody if you feeling the pressures of even, you know what I mean, feeling like showing anybody anything on social media on how you living and where you at and dropping any locations. Cause at the end of the day, they gonna egg it on and wait for it to happen, and then you gonna deal with the pain as long as, you know what I'm saying, as well as the family dealing with the pain. You understand what I'm saying? So with all this being said, man, we hope that this don't bring out a big all-out war. Because that's exactly what's going to happen, I think, bro. And I don't really want to say that's what's going to happen because it's like speaking it to existence. But you got to look at who y'all done hit up, bro. You know what I'm saying? This ain't just some, you know what I'm saying, regular guy. You know what I'm saying? When they hit up BBG Iraq, it wasn't some regular guy. These is dudes that really came up with the opposing side, allegedly. You see what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, they know each other very well. But see, with YB being watched by them people, and he being inside his own legal troubles, and then Quando Rondo bringing all that heat to his whole movement, it's like people is not being taken care of the way they supposed to, because the money is, you know what I'm saying, they, hey, look, it's getting financial as far as court systems and stuff like that. You see what I'm saying? So everybody that used to could go and chill with YB, you know what I'm saying? After that Bezo 187 situation, maybe, you know what I'm saying, he kind of fell back from a lot of people being around him. You don't know the situation. But at the end of the day, I just wanted to do this video just to, you know, give y'all an update on what's going on and what's really happening. Because it is a lot of things going on. For a lot of artists, as far as this dropping your location stuff, y'all need to let this be a prime example. And I'm talking about BR artists. I'm talking about Monroe, Louisiana. You know what I mean? I'm talking about Convict, Louisiana. You know what I'm saying? We talking about all of this. We talking about Lafayette. You know what I mean? I don't care who you is, man. Know what I mean? Streetport, I don't care where you at, bro. Let this be a testament that, bro, when you got things going on, and not go live, bro, because it's people that can't wait to see your downfall. You got some lame fans out here, bro, that are egging on to things like this happen and then come around and try to say how senseless it was. We see what you're doing. So at the end of the day, man, salute to the whole 100 Mob and drop no comments about how y'all feel about this whole situation, man, and what could have been done different, man. With all this being said, I'm out.